Hello my dear students, today we will see the basic construction of optical fiber. In the last session, we have discussed what is meant by total internal reflection and how optical fiber uses that particular phenomenon. Now see, optical fiber or the side view of optical fiber, it will be like this one. As we all know that for TIR, that is total internal reflection, there should be two mediums of different refractive indices. And the second one is, we know that the angle must be greater than its critical angle. And let us consider two different materials. The first one, the inner part of optical fiber, that inner part is called as a core. Let its refractive index be mu1. And the second one, outer part, is called as a cladding. Let its refractive index be mu2. Now remember, light will travel through this particular core section. Light will travel through this particular core section. This cladding will give the additional support to the optical fiber. And the outer post part, it is called as a coating or jacket. It acts or it covers the optical fiber from any other outer side effects. Now see, for total internal reflection, we all know that the refractive index or index of central medium, that is core, this mu1 has to be greater than this mu2, that is the refractive index of cladding. So here mu1 will be greater than mu2, then and then this total internal reflection will happen or it will be possible. Otherwise there will not be any total internal reflection. Now see, the material for cladding and core, we generally use glass material or sometimes plastic. That will depend upon the applications. Now here we'll see how light travels through this particular portion core and then how there is a total internal reflection takes place. Now see, if you consider, see, this one is the starting portion of core. Now light is made incident at this particular surface such that after a reflection or after refraction, there will be, or the light will go and it will hit the wall of the core medium such that the angle of incidence will be greater than its critical angle. Then what will happen after this incidence at greater than the critical angle? Whole of the light will get reflected in the same medium, and then again there will be continuous, or light will move in such a zigzag motion, and every time total internal reflection will take place. That will ensure that all of the light will remain in this particular core section. All of the light will remain in this particular core section. And no light will enter into this cladding. No light will enter into the cladding. So always remember these two things, that the refractive index of core, it has to be greater than this mu2 or the refractive index of cladding. And the second one is, light must incident at the wall of the core at an angle which is greater than its critical angle. So this is the basic construction of optical fiber and the basic working of optical fiber. Now we'll see cross-sectional view of optical fiber. Now see, in cross-sectional view of optical fiber, we'll able to see the central or the inner part, that is the core, in the form of circle like this one. Then the outer part, that is cladding, it will be again another concentric circle like this one. So this will be the cladding, and the outer part will be jacket. So this is cladding, this one, is cladding. This one is the core. And this outer part, it is what? It is jacket. Now see, on an average, the diameter of this core, it is approximately 50 micrometer. See, it will depend on the application. Again, in next session, we'll definitely see the different modes of operations of optical fiber. So, according to the mode, this diameter varies. Then, for this particular cladding, the diameter of cladding, it is around 125 micrometer. And for jacket, the diameter is around 150 micrometer. It will be what? Around 150 micrometer. So this is the overall view of optical fiber. Just remember these three parts. The inner one is the core. Then the outer one is cladding. And then final one is the jacket. Here jacket plays important role, that it gives or it protects the core and cladding material from any other outsider disturbances. And the cladding is specially, it is used to reduce the scattering loss at the core surface. So cladding reduces the scattering loss. Then it also enhances the mechanical strength of the optical fiber. So this is all about the basic construction of optical fiber and its basic working. My dear students, in next session, we will see the types of optical fibers. Thank you.